Hey, it's Fran again, and a little update on a project I've been doing here with these little green neon lamps. And I'm gonna stop down the camera a little bit here so I can show you. I started this experiment about 10 days ago, and I set this up with a sort of an arrangement of 33K current limiting resistors, one set to go to each lamp, and set them up in parallel to run right off of the AC, which at my bench right now is about 118 volts. And I just added some insulation, taped it down to a piece of cardboard, just so that it would be safe to sit on my bench and run for a week or so. And just set it up, and just started it running. In the lab, doing stuff, making something. In the lab, that's what I'm doing. Working out on the bench. In the lab, yeah. I cut the lead on this one so that I could attach it here, and here we go. So this one just has a couple hours of burn-in. I think after a few hours of running this, I detached this so that I could use it as a sample, as a control. These others have been running continuously for the last 10 days. This one has lost almost all of its phosphor. The others have lost all the phosphor in the middle. And I don't know if it's going to show up, but yes, yeah, oh yeah. Can see how it's really, really discernible purple glow in there. So it's clearly UV has obliterated the phosphors. And this is just after 10 days. So my project of restoring my Sony DT30 that I did a few weeks ago, where I replaced the original green neons in there with these modern Chinese-made green neons, it has not worked out well. The clock is now completely dark, and there is no green glow at all coming from it after just 3 weeks. And it's no surprise, because to see here just after 10 days, these are pretty much almost completely destroyed. So why? Why is this? You can see these two here. There's no neon glow in there at all. That's probably just argon and mercury. There might be a little bit of neon just as a filler gas, but it's most likely, well, there's probably neon in there because you need a little neon to be able to start up the plasma. Because argon, a lot of people, when they say this, oh, it's argon, it's argon, you know. No, you can't get argon to ionize at 120 volts. You need a lot more energy than that. But there's obviously some mercury in there to lower the conductance in the gas. But it's probably a combination of neon, argon, and mercury. But clearly, it's the UV from the mercury-argon mixture that is activating the phosphors, but these phosphors are now destroyed. So yeah, so these replacement lamps that I got, they're pretty much completely worthless. I mean, unless you're using these as indicators that are only on for very brief periods of time, and you run them at very low current, they're just not going to be good for illuminating anything. I mean, this doesn't make much sense because even like the composition of these lamps should be exactly the same as modern neon tubing or modern fluorescent light fixture tubing. But clearly not. The phosphors that they used in these little lamps are obviously not right. It shouldn't be so easy to destroy a phosphor. should have some longevity. Could you imagine if you had a fluorescent lighting fixture that you plugged in and 10 days later it was dark because all the phosphors had been destroyed? I mean, how hard can it be to pick a phosphor that could last more than 10 days? It shouldn't be hard at all. But here we are. My take on these replacement lamps is that they're basically utterly useless, which I guess leads to the big question, is there a manufacturer of phosphorescent lamps that actually uses the good phosphor that will actually run for years without just disintegrating and becoming destroyed by the UV? If anyone knows a manufacturer of really good phosphorescent lamps, please let me know. Leave a comment, and I'll be glad to get a bag and test them to destruction as well. But these guys, this is no good. So now I'm going to have to go back to the Sony and either replace the lamps with incandescents with green filters on them, or no, I'm not going to use LEDs. I'm not going to put LEDs. That would be stupid. But I'd really like to put a proper phosphorescent lamp in there to replace the ones that were originally in there to have the right glow. So if anyone knows anyone making a really good long-lasting phosphorescent green lamp, please leave a description in the comments. I've taken the test bed apart. I've got four lamps hooked up. Got the AC, and the limiting resistors are 33.5K apiece. Got the milliammeter set up. Alternating current, turn that on. And we're pulling 7 milliamps divided by four lamps, as we're doing 1.75 milliamps per lamp, which is practically nothing. So 1.75 mil per lamp, we just should not be pulling the kind of current that would destroy the lamps, you know, at less than 2 mils. So I don't know. And current voltage is 118 volts, so again, it's running these AC, which again, if I were running them DC, it would be much easier to think that they could be limited in their lifespan. But you know, running them AC, they should run longer because you know they're under a fluctuating duty cycle and all that stuff. So I don't know. It's just really bad phosphors. That's all it is. Oh well. All right. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks too to all my patrons down on the Patreon making all these videos possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I wouldn't be able to do any of this without my amazing patrons. All right. I'll be back here in the lab with something maybe not as disappointing, but certainly something as interesting real soon. Bye! Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. Watching. Friend love, it's what I'm doing.
working at the bench.